Depending who you ask, it can take a lot of effort and a lot of time to get to 3. But now we know that at least it's possible. Congratulations, AMD, on making it to 3. Even if you had to count backwards from 7 and skip a few numbers in between. Meet Ryzen 3, the entry-level FU to the team in blue. Browse privately and securely with TunnelBear, the simple VPN app. Start your 7-day free trial at the link in the video description. So if you've been living under a rock for the past 6 months, like I did that one time, this release might have snuck up on you. It's okay, we get it. Money doesn't grow on trees, you got bills to pay and mouths to feed, am I right? Well, AMD figures there's a lot of truth to that, and Ryzen 3, the final piece of the puzzle, comes in at $110 to $130. And if you look at what Intel's done with Kaby Lake's Pentium lineup, it is clear that they saw this coming and felt like they needed to react. Where Pentium CPUs have been two-core, two-thread-only affairs for several generations, now the CPUs that compete with Ryzen 3 on pricing are going to four-thread using hyper-threading for the first time, blurring the lines between Pentium and Core i3, which, I guess I'm finally gonna have to redo this 3-year-old video. But is Intel's response even adequate? Ryzen 3, very pointedly, doesn't have simultaneous multi-threading, but is instead a full-on quad-core CPU made up of two of AMD's Zen Compute Complexes, or CCXs. This means that while it has only half the cache of its Ryzen 5 and Ryzen 7 cousins, it has all the same features that they provide, like SenseMI, Precision Boost, and XFR. Though, since AMD is still disabling cores symmetrically, cache latency is technically higher than if they had used a single CCX with 4 cores. And, as we showed in our Ryzen 5 review, while this method saves AMD some cost, it also reduces the amount of total bandwidth available to the cache. So the question becomes, will we see an appreciable loss in performance? And if so, can Ryzen 3 keep up with the best Team Blue has to offer within this price bracket? Well, AMD considers the closest price competitor to the Ryzen 3 1300X to be the Core i3 7300 and the Ryzen 3 1200 to be the Core i3 7100. And from a pricing standpoint, this is roughly correct. As for performance though, AMD actually managed to pull out a solid win thanks to Ryzen 3's multi-threaded performance, especially at these prices. Consistently, in nearly every area that doesn't involve purely single-threaded performance, both Ryzen 3 chips handily beat out both of their Intel competitors. Unfortunately for AMD, that doesn't include most current games where dual-core Core i3s are able to pull off higher frame rates, but with that said, our use of a clean Windows image for our testing doesn't tell us how background processes might affect gaming performance on a system that actually has just 2 cores versus 4 true cores. But even ignoring that, when you crunch the numbers and look at the value proposition, Ryzen 3 makes a lot of sense. Not only does the 1300X never fall behind its Team Blue rival, the Ryzen 3 1200 also makes a great showing. It is certainly looking very bright overall for Ryzen 3 when you look at the big picture. And there's yet another trick up Ryzen's sleeve, and that's overclocking. Unlike Intel, whose CPUs probably have a ton of headroom in them, but are locked for overclocking unless you shell out for a K-series, Ryzen 3 is fully unlocked, just like the Ryzen 5 and Ryzen 7 lineups. And when you spend a little bit of time doing some tuning, gaming performance comes much closer to Team Blue. Not to mention that it also further increases AMD's lead in multi-threaded non-gaming benchmarks. Our Ryzen 3 1200 managed to overclock past the 1300X's stock clocks, making it an incredible value at this speed and this price. Though, as always with overclocking, your mileage may vary. And some additional investment is required for overclocking. You'll need an overclocking compatible motherboard chipset and a decent cooler. The Wraith Stealth included in the box is fine, but it's not enough to handle a voltage bump big enough to comfortably overclock it all the way to the max. So be prepared to spend a little more if you want to squeeze some extra juice out of your Ryzen 3, should you pick one up. And pick one up, you probably should. The platform's matured a lot, and Ryzen 3 rips back the budget market that AMD has come to rely on since Sandy Bridge. And while, like the rest of its family, it doesn't exactly dominate, it throws a big ol' Randy Johnson curveball at Team Blue and provides a legitimate alternative to value shoppers who still want great performance. We're partnering with Razer at LTX 2017 to host a Razer Goliathus Mouse Mat Design Contest. The theme is, well, me. We're gonna see who can design the best Linus Tech Tips themed Razer Goliathus mouse pad. Attendees of LTX will be able to submit their designs online. Razer will select the top four, and then it will be up to you to vote on which one is the best. If you haven't gotten your ticket for LTX 2017, you still can at the link below. We're hosting it here in Langley, BC, Canada. There's gonna be tons of cool stuff with some exclusive unboxings, including a very special one from Razer, and something about teasing an upcoming review. Don't miss it. I don't know what that means. Colton wrote this. So thanks for watching, guys. If this video sucked, you know what to do. But if it was awesome, get subscribed, hit the like button, or check out the link to where to buy the stuff we featured in the video description. Also linked down there is our merch store, which has cool shirts like this one, and our community forum, which you should totally join.